can't call a meeting order. We're gonna open a meeting. I will open the meeting, a non-meeting. How's that?
That's fine. So no minute approval and no approvals of any kind? No actions taken at this meeting?
No. Manager's report, I'm sorry. Good thing you said that.
Having just gotten back from vacation, I did not have a ton of sheet for you this month. I'll have it obviously for July and August next month for you.
I hope you had a good vacation.
Absolutely. Yesterday in the Republican American Litchfield County section, Salisbury Sharon Towns get state grant to be spent on recycling. So I'll send you a copy of the press release.
You did.
There's a copy of the press release. $45,000 to municipal, the seven communities. Six parties applied. So obviously we are the applicant that had two towns. So we're gonna be part of a grant for $6,953. And that goes into the grant program that we talked about a couple meetings ago. There's a whole list of things that we can use to be reimbursed on. So they're not actually giving us the money. They will reimburse us for a future expenditure.
Nice work.
What do you do to encourage recycling? The schools, is that through the schools? Is that what most of it is?
And going through the garbage bags. The, on DEP's website, I think it was 2008, they have a copy of the letters that I sent out back then. So if you throw a bag of garbage into the hopper and it goes jingle, 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 very often I'll grab that bag out, go through it, take pictures, send them a letter when I find mail, because usually if they've thrown recycling out, they've left personal information in there so they know who it is. And so anyway, DEP has a you know, sanitized version of that letter. That's about it.
I'd like to see that money go towards the recreation recycling in some way. I think that's where it's most needed. The parks, the green, the field. We've got to figure that out.
It's for containers?
For pickup disposal. The containers are, I think, cheap. I don't know, but that would be where I'd like to see that money spent.
And that recreational usage part, I mean, that's, it's...
It's where you get the most recap.
It's also a place where you don't always have activity, but then you do. So, I mean, just...
I mean, you have, but you have the pavilion down there that's used quite often, and...
We're talking about Sharon, right?
Yeah, Sharon.
Salisbury has the Grove.
I think they already do something there in Salisbury.
They, well, yeah, the discussion last meeting, Barbara felt that it was less than optimal or adequate, that Salisbury, even at the Grove, needed improvement. There was no, she was very, very strong about that.
Well, I think that's where we really make a difference. I mean, I think a lot of this is good ideas, but if we really want to recapture the recycling, that's where we can do it.
I got it. Go ahead, Bill.
Do you mean the green container with a little hole for cans and things, and then a second container for waste?
We need one at the field, and we need one on the green, minimum. We fill them up on a weekend basis.
I got an email from Patricia I didn't forward to you. I'll read it to you. I'm not able to attend the meeting Wednesday. Checked out Town of Sharon Beach and Town Fields trash and recycling bins. Both have trash bins or barrels, no recycle bins in either place. At least they were not evident to me. The following will work. One recycling bin, she needs a container of sorts, for beach area picked up by Welch for trash. Four recycling bins for Town Fields pavilion, tennis courts, and near front ball field. I believe a sturdy, simple design will work in these areas. Nothing fancy should be needed. I'm not sure if Welch picks up at Town Fields. So that's in the minutes of last meeting. We identified the town-owned properties. Salisbury would be the town grove, Trotta Field on Salmon Kill Road, Community Field by the mobile station there, and then the school athletic fields. In Sharon, we identified the town beach, town fields. There was a question mark at the town green. I don't know whether something...
Probably a question mark because it's in the historic district.
Yes, yeah, and that was a, you know, we did. And then in both places, the school athletic fields. Other potential public areas that are not town-owned are the Marketplace Shopping Center by LeBons and that whole area up to Main Street, and then the Sharon Shopping Center, I think it's called, the shopping area.
Plaza. Makes it sound Italian, you know?
So, but, and then...
I imagine that would be seasonal. The beach would be seasonal.
Right.
You know, the green would be seasonal with the summer concerts. You have people just throwing, you know, the bottles that they bring to drink wherever. So, I mean, we're really interested in recapturing and using this money for recycling. That, to me, is where it should be used.
The green may be satisfied by... under who organizes events on the green?
The partner.
Matt.
Okay. Because Brian has those
loaners, if you will, right?
Portable. And that may satisfy the historical district.
Because it would not be permanent.
That's right. But yet it would be there because, you know, there's not a lot of activity on the green.
Right.
This is an event. But there's a lot of events.
Yeah,
is there a park and runner after those Wednesday concerts? I live further down the green, so I'm not really aware of the litter.
I'm not saying there's litter. I'm saying there's a, if we want to recapture the recycling, that's what we should do.
But it's a park and rec when they scheduled or permitted an event. Maybe we just needed that. Maybe it's just nothing more than a level of awareness that they let the person that's doing the event know that these are available and they're, you know, they're expected to be.
How many do you have that are temporary right now?
25.
Okay. How often do they get used?
Not very.
Okay.
Yeah. So that would be, that would satisfy both the need and then how do you do they pick them up? Do you drop them off?
Or pick them up. Okay. Deliver them back.
So whoever it grabs them is in charge of the disposal and all that and bringing it in. Okay.
So if there was an extra expense involved, then this grant might be able to help that out. I mean, it
doesn't sound like there would be. If it's a temporary thing for an event, then there wouldn't be.
I mean, I would think if anything, you buy some to have at each.
As a permanent fixture?
No, at each town hall or at each, you know. Not everybody's going to drive all the way up or all the way down, whichever town you're in.
Right.
So for...
There's something else for Tina to do, is give out the temporary...
Oh, but I mean, go through Parks and Rec or
we can figure it out just a little bit. No, I think that's a really good idea. If we had our own temporary ones for events.
You get a lot for that.
Veterans Field would be a different situation, as with Sharon Beach. They would need a permanent one for...
Not necessarily.
The season.
A seasonal one, a seasonal/permanent one.
One
that you have to take.
Yeah, permanent.
Permanent for those.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right. If you move it, you move it, but it's not going to be a temporary that you're going to leave out for 4 months.
No. You know? Exactly. Okay. Yeah. So maybe just figuring out how many, you know, those permanent ones we would need, and then get our own cachet of the season, the one-time use things.
Well, how many garbage cans are out? That would be the whole question.
Patricia.
For each garbage can, you need to have
a recycling
can. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. There you go.
Now there's two at the field right now, and there's one, at least one at the beach.
And what are they using?
They're using the gray with a dome top.
Is that a swinging door?
Yeah.
A 55-gallon drum or a plastic toter brute?
Yeah,
it's not a brute bin.
No, it's...
It's a more sturdy than
that.
No, plastic.
It's plastic. It's a composite 55 at least, but they're just loaded with recycling and pizza boxes.
Right.
And what do they do with them in the winter? Do they stay out there, they take them in?
I'm not sure, I think they stay. I'm not sure 100% on that. I'd have to ask Matt.
Because they could do the same thing, just put a recycling container beside it. And if they go in for the winter, they go in and come back out.
Tim, could you ask Matt?
Sure.
And then just get back to me and then funnel it back?
Yeah, I'll see how long he does.
Ask how many he's got in each of those places and what, how long they stay out?
Yep.
That'd be great.
Sure.
Okay.
And then we'll decide on a container. As Patricia said, it doesn't have to be elaborate.
Well, I know that Brian's got ideas about what kind of containers.
They certainly don't need to be elaborate, but they should be uniform.
Yes, and they should be recognizable as a recycling container.
And the same one in Salisbury as in Sharon.
I would think so.
Might as well, yeah.
Are they raccoon-proof?
Critter-proof?
Well, the garbage, the...
You're gonna have more problem with the garbage than you are with recycling, so...
I'll forward the picture from Under Mountain Road where the bear got into the people's garbage and it was full of recyclables. He strewed the recyclables all over the Berkshire School Road and took the garbage. So they won't get in the recycling.
So he's sorting already?
Well, they did.
Single stream.
Did he separate the ones that are 5 cents?
No, he didn't. But it was interesting that they obviously weren't recycling.
Non-edible.
And yeah, non-edible. And you could see it. I'll forward to the picture. I took it a couple of years ago and sent it out.
Grant money to train bears, okay.
So they generally don't go for the recycling bin.
But the trash they go in.
They're gonna go for the trash.
And they don't get empty very often, right, so...
Only when somebody complains that they're...
And they don't go in the trash ones? Do they get tipped over all the time or are they okay?
It's not a problem down the field. I think they're mostly after, it's, you know, right now they're after bird seed, mostly the easy pickings.
Do those tops sort of go on so that it's hard for a raccoon to get in?
Depends on them. You've got A to Z of designs and...
But they're gonna go for the garbage can.
Yeah.
Before they'll go for the recycling.
So it sounds like one use for this grant money would be, you know, to at least provide Sharon with some of these temporary disposal containers and then a couple more permanent ones. I don't know how much money we're talking about. That can't be the whole grant.
No.
I think they're 50 or 60 bucks.
Yeah, no, it's nominal.
Right.
But it's needed, it really is.
Oh, no, totally. I'm just trying to tally up where we're at with the grant money.
You know, my theory is town should be doing it now. But that's...
Well, they will be doing it.
Yeah.
Well, it brings up the whole thing that we talked about months ago, who's gonna collect it?
And that's the next part, right?
You know?
I mean, if we're talking...
Is that a contract issue? Is it a, you know, a union contract issue? Is it a contract for the hauler? Is it a...
Right.
You know?
But Patricia said one recycling bin for each, for the beach area, picked up by Welch. She doesn't know about the fields or really the tenement tennis court. I'm not sure if Welch picks up at town fields.
I don't think so.
And so that's a whole other issue then, that they are not getting emptied anyway, so...
Matt throws them in the back of, at least when I was coaching baseball, he would throw them in the back of his pickup truck and drive them over and do it himself. But, you know, has anybody tried to negotiate this with, you know, my point is maybe out of, for us giving them so much business from our town folks that they'd be willing to
Welch.
Tell them it. Yes, I mean, has anybody tried to negotiate it with them?
No, probably nobody's strong.
Well, actually Brian is nodding his head that he has spoken to them before and they have said no, but...
Yeah, they said yes for a fee.
Yeah, right.
They'd be happy to.
Right.
Both haulers said the same thing.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Well, it'd be good to know how much time it takes for Matt, for example, to do the emptying of the garbage and how much more time it would take him to deal with a recycling bin too.
I think it's a selectman issue.
I do too.
I think certainly we, through the grant, could purchase however many bins we think is appropriate to make them available to each town. because then each town has its own channels that it has to go through.
Yeah.
Whether the selectmen are going to decree it, or if it's going to go to department heads, or, you know, how it's going to actually flush out.
Well, I'd definitely be in favor of getting these bins.
Yes, I agree, and then it'll figure itself out.
Okay.
It will, yes, it will figure itself out.
I can ask the people in the town of Richfield what they do, because I go to an event every week, and it's really large, and it's in Ballard Park, and sometimes a lot of people attend, so they bring extra garbage cans and the recycling bin right next to it, which I use almost all the time.
It's temporary.
And then they take them away the very next day, because, or they take, have most of them away, because they don't want tons of them there, they just want the one or two that they usually have, and they want to take the other four or five away.
Yeah.
So, and I can ask the...
Yeah, email me, let me know.
If it's something that their Board of Recreation does, or if the entity that puts on the concert takes care of it.
Yeah.
How does Salisbury handle the garbage cans it has in public areas?
Like at the Grove, like at the Grove.
They use Welsh as well.
Grove takes care of their own.
So the manager of the Grove will take the garbage to the transfer station?
I thought Curtis said that they use Welsh, that they pay Welsh to pick them up.
Welsh picks up the garbage at the Grove.
Not there, and there's recycling there as well?
Yeah. But the manager take, or has somebody take care of that?
Somebody from the Grove drives it up.
Okay.
And then the...
And is it part of the Grove's, is it part of the, is it part of their operating expenses, or is it part of... Like, does the Grove actually pay for Welsh, or does it...
Yeah, you know, and that's a good point. It might very well be able to come out of the rec budget, you know, at least for the field and the beach. That's under the rec direction as well.
Yes, it is. That's where I'm thinking.
So.
Right.
You have a little place to pair their own. It would be much easier, wouldn't it?
But I assume the beach has more than one garbage can.
I think it only has one public garbage can.
It might have two. It might have two.
If it has another one, Sim, it might be one that the staff handles themselves.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think there's only one public one, though.
Okay. It could be one for Little Rascals and one for out on the...
True, and they may handle their own. Right. More study is needed.
Okay. Yeah, I'll go down and take a look.
Let me know what you figured out. And I'll figure out who
is what. My kids are working down there. I can just ask them. Hey, I'm going to...
Exactly. My daughter worked down there last year. I should ask her.
But you feel if the bins were to appear...
We'll figure out a way to make this happen. I mean, I would love to be able to project how much we'd be able to increase our recycling from our town by if we were to do that. I would love to be able to figure out how to estimate that. But anyway, sorry.
Probably, I don't know. Well, what you do is you go down and do a dumpster dive.
The point is getting it to where it belongs as far as, you know, to me, this grant is, that's what you should use for.
Right, okay. So that's one option, to use this grant.
Okay.
All right. But obviously that's not all of it.
No.
To be continued.
Well, yeah, the other... Okay, so...
So at our next meeting, Sim and I will have more information about, you know, exactly what we've got and who's doing what with our garbage and any recycling that does take place.
Yeah, and then we may have to, you know, do some work in Salisbury.
Okay.
Within...
Okay.
I have to see where Curtis, you know, in the department head. The Grove is a little bit more established in the department.
Right.
Then so it might not be quite as easy for us to accomplish that in Salisbury.
Well, but I think the biggest complaint was that the Grove doesn't recycle.
Right.
As far as I know, there's a recycling bin next to the garbage can. Now, whether it's effective, that's a different story.
Okay.
But if you walk down, you know, go into the main parking lot, walk around, everywhere there's a garbage can, there is a recycling bin.
But it's probably not identifiable.
I don't know.
Okay.
Pictures.
Have to look at
Take
that.
Some pictures.
Okay.
Because that's the law now, I think. Didn't it pass last year? You have to have a recycle bin next to a trash container.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. back up then to the pilot food scrap program.
Hi, Bill.
Thanks. Started out that we were thinking of doing something on the commercial. There are some increases in some commercial accounts billings for the month. And so they were looking at, and this notice, you know, this was sent out a year ago, so it's, but now when the bill comes, you get their, you know, they get focused on it. And then the last time we met, we talked about expanding it over into a drop-off at the transfer station. Ned Harvey had said, let's put a firm date on of September to start this. The idea was run it through December. We were going to figure out what the cost might be and where, how we could fund it. So that's sort of, so I think Ryan has.
Ryan has a wet towel. Wet towel to throw the whole thing. I think we need to slow it right down now. And form a subcommittee. That subcommittee is also going to do a grant to DEP for that section three of the grants.
Okay.
And tie it all right in there, get whatever data they need for the grant. Because in terms of coming up with a cost, short of going through their garbage can and finding out how much organic material you're gonna be able to pull out, I have no idea how much business A, B, or C is gonna contribute on a weekly basis towards a tonnage fee. Talking with one of the haulers, just kind of as a sounding board, depending on where the stops are, if they're kind of not too far apart, you could probably do six stops in an hour. Well, when we were down in Wingdale, I think $100 an hour was kind of a thought for a man in the truck, so maybe it's 110 now, I don't know. If you're coming from, you know, how far is it? If either hauler that's currently in town were coming, they're probably the same distance out of either town. You know, is it 2 hours a run? If you're doing six or seven stops, well, now you're up to $240 just for collection. If you're collecting it three times a week, you know, you're going through a lot of money very quickly, regardless of the tip fee. So I think we need to slow it right down. I need help to go through it, make it as part of the grant. You know, especially if we're gonna be, if the consensus is to use the money that we've already been awarded, you know, as a reimbursable towards containers. You know, there's much more money available in that section three.
I think the thing's up to 20,000 in there.
Yeah, I believe, well, I don't know if it's a population, but that's per town. But I believe there's a population key to that as well.
How long do you think it would take you to study this before you could come up with a suggestion of what our next steps would be?
We need to print out the paperwork for the grant and start looking through it. You know, the question is do we need to go out to bid on it as an actual formal package? That it's a 6 month thing, you know, start in January and go through June. You know, what, you know, that way nobody can say that they weren't offered the opportunity or, you know, what are the different regulations.
Okay.
So
sounds reasonable.
We need collection frequency, right?
And that's going to be a seasonal difference,
yeah,
most likely. Summertime, you're probably three times a week. Wintertime, as long as the volume is not too large of the business, you can go down to once a week. It's just a matter of, you know, how much organic material they're going to produce.
Who is they?
Businesses that you would select to be in a
pilot.
In a pilot
program. Right.
Yeah. What I think, can't make any decisions, but it might be prudent for us to hold out the balance of this grant that we've received to put towards the other one too. that would be a great use for that also.
And DEP has not come out with an actual contract that the towns are gonna have to sign for that $6,900, because it's gonna prescribe what timeframe you have to use it.
Okay.
You know, they're still working that through internally.
Okay.
And Jen Waymouth from DEP is back from vacation on Monday, so I'll get more information next week.
Okay, I can't, because we don't have a quorum, I can't appoint a separate.
Can't you as chairman?
It's not a real meeting.
Can't be as chairman, regardless of a meeting?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
If he's chairman, can form a subcommittee.
Right, and it's a non-meeting, he can do whatever he wants, I guess. As long as we're not passing a motion.
Okay, oh, then I can act as chairman, okay.
Can I guess, or ask a question? So we're trying to get a handle on how much these selected businesses are going to generate. Is that what the question at hand is? Would it be worthwhile to designate a container for the three top contenders or something like that for a month or two? And say that whatever you do organically for that timeframe will take away and not charge you a tip fee on and weigh those and get a better handle on it for a couple months and make it easy?
No. Maybe a couple of times.
Couple of times?
Not over a couple of months.
Or a month?
I have no way to handle it.
But we're talking mainly about restaurants, right?
Not necessarily.
No?
Could be private schools.
Okay.
Could be all sorts of different things.
Well, do we have a list of people that we...
I have seven places in mind.
I don't think it hurts to say who they are.
I'd like to talk to them before we...
Okay, that's true.
Are they different sectors of food?
Yes.
There's four in Salisbury and three in Sharon.
Nice waiting.
So maybe we could take a sampling, one of each particular type that we're looking at, and say, can you throw your organics in here for the month that we're trying to figure this out and see how much they do or not?
A month is way too long. They're not gonna do it for a month.
A week?
I can't imagine they're gonna do it for...
I think you can just ask them, they know.
I think it depends on the business. You know, it's a matter of doing a quick dive in their dumpster a couple of times and get a rough idea.
If they're a restaurant, they know.
Most of the businesses, we have weights from previous history.
Because it's lost.
So if I can come up with a percentage, it's just, I can't do it to start September 1st.
Okay.
And the money that's gonna be expended, it's a much deeper dive to figure out what that cost is gonna be. Then we're gonna have to present to DEP for the grant anyway.
Okay.
But I need help with it.
Okay.
Don't we wanna see what we're getting and what they're actually gonna be doing? I mean, don't we want a real-world sampling, is my point? Saying that they're gonna do it and doing it is sometimes two different things. And also, if they're gonna be throwing, if they can't do it. In other words, if they can't do it properly up to our standards, then it doesn't make sense for them to do it. So don't we want a real-world sampling upfront before these decisions are made, if we can get that or not?
I don't understand what you're asking. What timeframe are you talking about?
Well, tell them, here's one container, fill it up, call us when it's full. And we'll come and look at it and see what you got in there and see how long it took you to fill it up. Wouldn't that be better than...
And then what do you do with the container?
You dump it in, you just dump it.
How do you get it from their business to somewhere else?
Well, how are you gonna, I mean, won't you just dump it in the back of, I mean, you could have Welch pick it up, or you don't have the capability to pick it up?
I don't have the capability to pick it up.
We could have a homework. That's a good, but we could work through this on a subcommittee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
I just think we need a sample of...
I don't think there's any decision, obviously no decision can be made tonight, but I think this is something that's gonna be brought up in September and October, we're gonna continue to discuss it. And at that point, October, we may have enough information to actually say, yes, let's submit the grant, and this is what we know.
I'd like to recommend that Ned be asked to be on that.
Ned?
I'd like to recommend Sim, since he's bringing up some really good comments. And Barbara.
Okay, I will point those three. Now that's scheduled meeting time, that is the meeting room. Yeah, and be clear, Dr. Brian, I didn't necessarily think that September 1st was the.
No, no, I'm just asking Sim what it, you know.
I just think we need a sampling of what we're gonna get and how much, I mean.
A real life sample.
You know, just, yeah, real life sampling before we're making any decisions on it.
And it doesn't have to be a large garbage can.
No.
It could be something with the.
And if it's gonna be half, if it's gonna be stuff that gets thrown in there and it's not sorted, then we know that they're not a good candidate.
Yeah, like Hotchkiss School, but had that challenge at Salisbury.
Yeah, if they can't do it, they can't, you know.
This should be easier because of the, where the source of it's coming out of the kitchen.
It should be, yeah, but.
But, you know, there's a surprise under, you know, there around every corner.
And there's gonna have to be training for them over there to even consider doing it. They're gonna have to be shown how to do it and what can go and what can't go. I mean, it's not just turn a switch, right?
And then as Brian said, we have to contact to see if they want to participate.
Right.
That's the first step.
Yep.
So I guess the first.
I think it makes a lot of sense to have these three people sit down and roll out all these questions.
So I guess the first thing, yes, first thing is identify the potential candidates, then contact them.
And then what the procedure's gonna be first, right?
Yeah.
Procedure, yeah.
Okay.
Right.
I think that's all we have on the agenda.
And we can't adjourn.
No, okay.
Can we leave?
We can't leave. Sorry, was there ever a.